Hello and welcome to another Sea of Power Scripts tutorial with me, Christian Rauchenwald. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use the CF Pretty Bump Power Script to improve the look and feel of your order bumps on your order forms, and also to add images to those order bumps if you want to, and to use more than one order bump on your order form as well. Now, in order to get started, as always, you need to log into your CF Power Scripts account. And once there, head from the dashboard to the Power Script section. Now within your Power Script section, you want to make sure to pick the funnel where you want to add the Pretty Bump script to. And I am, as usual, going to pick my development funnel. And there you want to go to the order form where you want to add the CF Pretty Bump Power Script to. Now I have two order forms in that specific funnel, a two-step order form and a regular order form. We're going to start with the regular order form to show you how everything works. And then we're going to also cover the two-step order form to show you the slight differences there are when it comes to the setup. So for that, I'm going to click on the order form funnel step and you should do the same. If you're running a split test like I'm doing here, you will see two funnel step pages here. If you don't run a split test, you will only see one. And as you can see, I've already added the script here, but I'm going to quickly remove it. And then the first thing we want to do is we want to click on the icon next to the funnel step page. And we want to click on open in ClickFunnels to open that specific page in ClickFunnels. And here we want to go to the products tab. Now, once we have the products tab open, we can go back to CF Power Scripts and we click on open in page editor to open that specific funnel step in ClickFunnels page editor. And you will need to do that for both versions of your funnel step if you're running a split test. Now, once we scroll down on that order form, you can see that I have an order bump element here and an image element here. So if you want to use an image with your order bumps, you need to create an image element. Simply select the image that you want to use for your order bump, and then go to get CSS info by clicking on the hashtag icon and change the title of that element to bump minus IMG for image and click on update. Additionally, it's worth mentioning that the settings of that image elements are also going to be copied. So you can see that I have set a negative margin of minus 50 that actually moves the image element upwards. So that will be copied. And also when you go to the advanced settings, you can play around with the align options, so left, center, and right, because that will also be considered. And depending on where you place the image and what kind of image you're using, so if it's a landscape or a portrait image, it will make a difference in the look later on your funnel. Now, once we've done that, we simply head back to CF Power Scripts, we close the pop-up, and we click on Add New and look for the CF Pretty Bump Power Script, and click on it, and we walk through the settings. So as you can see, we have a couple of settings here. The first one is the optional bump image position. So when you're using a bump image like I'm doing in this case, you can pick if it should be on the left side or on the top. And in most cases, you will want to pick top here. It depends on the width of your order form area, if it makes sense to have it on the left and also on the kind of image. So in my case, where I have that landscape image with the collection of books, it would not look nice on the left of the text because it would get too small in terms of the height. So it makes sense to place it on top, but you can just play around and change it later to find the right setting for your specific order bump. Now I'm going to pick top here. And the next thing you can choose here is the order bump layout. You can choose between a horizontal and a vertical layout. I'm going to show you the difference in a moment. However, in most cases, the vertical layout will fit better unless you have a very wide order form. So I'm also going to pick vertical here. The last thing is a color selector that allows you to pick the color of the headline within the new created order bump. I'm just going to leave our default color here and click on add script. And when we click on the icon again and we click on open live or preview funnel step, we can see once we scroll down that we don't have our regular order bump element, but that it uses our pretty bump element that looks like this. Now, because we place the image on top and have a negative margin on the image, you can see that the image stands out on top of the order bump element, which I like in this case here. But again, you can just adjust the settings of your image element in the editor to influence that. And you can see the color for the headline that it's using here, and the add button to actually add that order bump is added at the bottom because we picked the vertical layout over the horizontal layout. Now, just to show you the difference, if we go back and I edit the script and I change the layout to horizontal with the image on the left side and we save it and we go back and we refresh our funnel step, you can see that this actually doesn't look nice at all because the order form is not wide enough on the page. So of course the image is now too much on top because of the negative margin that we entered here. So I would need to set that to zero or even a positive value to get the image centered here. But because it's a landscape image and not a portrait perspective image, it will never look nice on the left side. And also the button doesn't fully fit because there's simply not enough space available. Now there are situations where this layout will actually look nice. It depends a lot on the image settings that you have for your order bump image, or if you're not using an order bump image at all, and on the width of your order form element. So you simply need to play around a little bit here to find the perfect settings. But in most cases, it will be having the image on top or no image at all and using the vertical layout. So that's how you can use the CF Pretty Bump power script in your funnels at ClickFunnels for your regular order form with one order bump. All you need to do is, as always, add an order bump element, change the text of the order bump element as you would usually do, and change the title tag of the image that you want to use for your bump image. Now, if we were to look at our two-step order form, for that, I'm going to go back and I'm going to pick our two-step order form funnel step. There we already have the script edit again with top and vertical and the same color setting. And I'm going to open the first two-step order form here because it also only contains one order bump. Now, as you can see, when we go to the second step of the funnel, it looks the same. It creates that nice looking pretty bump with the button here and the image on top, again with a negative margin to the image to make it stand out on top a little bit. When we open that funnel step in the page editor, you can see it works in exact the same way. We just have our regular two-step order form element, and here in the settings we filled in the text for the order bump, the bump headline, and so on. And in the advanced settings we enabled the order bump to show order bump. And additionally we have an image element that has the title tag bump minus image to use it within the order bump. For most of you, that will already be enough since most people only use one order bump. However, if you want to use two or more order bumps on your funnels, pay close attention because I'm going to show you how that works as well. So for now, I'm going to close this order form and I'm also going to close the other pages that we opened along the way. And here we're going to head back to our regular order form to start there. Now I accidentally also closed the ClickFunnels page that we opened earlier, but it's not a problem. I'm just going to click on the icon again and click again on opening ClickFunnels to open that specific funnel step and go to products. Now, when we go back and we open the variation funnel step in that case, because that already has two order bumps in it, so I don't need to adjust too much. In the page editor, and we scroll down, you can see that I have one image and a bump here and another image and a bump here. So we just add two order bump elements and two image elements. However, we need to map them properly. Now, in order to do that, when we go back to ClickFunnels to the product section of that specific order from funnel step, you can see that we have three regular products. It's a subscription product, a payment plan, and a one-time product. And there are two different bump products called Order Bump 2 and Order Bump 1, although the names are unfortunately reversed. The important thing to understand here is that you also need to add your order bumps as regular products, and only the last product that you add gets the setting Order Bump. Now, in order to make that product an actual order bump within your funnel, you need to click on Edit and copy the product ID of that product, which you can find in the URL in the browser's address bar. There you will see clickfunnels.com/funnelsteps/a number that indicates the funnel step ID /products, and the next number, the last number within the URL, is your product's ID. So you just highlight it and copy it either by pressing Control or Command C or by right clicking and selecting copy, and you go back to the page editor. Now within the page editor, for the order bump elements, you click on the order bump element and again you go to Get CSS Info by clicking on the hashtag icon, and you need to change the title to CFPS-Multi-Bump minus the product ID. Now I already did that for this element, so I'm not going to overwrite the product ID that's here, but just to show you how it's done. Once you've added that title tag, you simply click on update, and then you also need to do the same for the order bump image if you want to use one. So you add a new image element, you select the image that you want to use, and you make sure that your image settings, your margin, and the align, so center, left, or right, are set properly. And then again, you click on the hashtag icon to open the CSS info. And there, similar to how it works with one order bump, you need to change the title to bump minus IMG minus the product ID. And this way, our power script knows which image belongs to which order bump. Once you've done that, you simply go back to ClickFunnels, you hit the back button, no need to save anything here, and you select your next product that should serve as an order bump. And you repeat that same process for all your order bumps. So if we check that order bump here and we go to CSS info, you can see that it has a different product ID in the title tag, and the same goes for this image ID here. Now, in your case, again, you would need to go back to CF PowerScript and add the CF Pretty Bump PowerScript by clicking on Add New and selecting the script. But since we already have the script added, we can just go to preview the funnel step or look at the live funnel step. And when we scroll down, you can see that we have two order bumps here, both using the Pretty Bump layout and both working independent from each other. Now, that would be a case where the image align on the left actually makes sense. So when we go back and we edit the script, and we just change the setting here from top to left and click save and head back to reload the page. You can see that for images like ebook covers, it actually fits very nice having the image on the left side. Now, again, you could play around with the image settings itself. So with the margin and the align of left, center and right to align it a little bit better. But you can already see that for images that are in a portrait perspective or aspect ratio, it actually works very nice and doesn't use as much space. So that's how you would add multiple order bumps to your funnels using the CF Pretty Bump script on your regular order form. Now let's take a look at how it works with your two-step order form. So for that, I'm gonna go back to the CF PowerScript section and I'm gonna jump quickly to our two-step order form funnel step. And there we are going to open the funnel step in the page editor. Now, when we scroll down here, you can see that we have two image elements. And again, just like on the regular funnel, those image elements have title tags that are bump minus IMG minus the product ID of the order bump that they are assigned to. And additionally, we have one order bump element. And it has, again, the title tag CFPS minus multi minus bump minus the product ID. Additionally, within the two-step order form in the advanced settings, we enabled the order bump here. So it uses one of the order bumps that is already within the two-step order form. Now, when we click preview here, since we already added the power script for this funnel as well, and we go to the second step of the two-step order form, you can see it works in exact the same way. We have one order bump here and the second one here. Now, don't get confused that it says order bump 2 and order bump 1 in this order here. That's purely my mistake for naming the order bumps in the wrong order here. So I named this one order bump 2 and the last one order bump 1, when you actually would have this one your first order bump and that one your second order bump and so on. But in the end, you're anyway going to use your actual product names. And you just need to make sure that they are in the right order. So starting with your regular product and then following your order bump product. And only the last order bump actually gets the setting order bump in the product settings. Now that's it. That's how easy you can use the CF Pretty Bump power script in your funnels at ClickFunnels to not only improve the look of your order bumps, but also add images to them if you want to. And also use multiple order bumps on one funnel step alone, which will increase your average cart value quite a lot. Now, as always, if you have any questions whatsoever about this PowerScript, make sure to check the FAQ section on cfpowerscripts.com. And if you cannot find the answer there, either create a post within our Facebook community, or if you're a member of our VIP plan, use the live chat within the Slack application and reach out there to us. Thanks for watching, and even more so, thanks for using CF PowerScripts. See you in one of our other videos. Till then, bye-bye.